Welcome to the first edition of Roblox Discussion. In this series, I give my thoughts on various Roblox-related topics that may or may not be suggested by you. Go on, leave them in the comments. Today's topic is something that has been quite controversial among the Roblox community throughout 2017. If you read the title of the video, or perhaps looked at the thumbnail, you know exactly what I'm talking about. This is known as chat. Huh? Where's about the chat? Are you kidding me? Okay, that explains a lot. There we go. We're talking about Roblox's chat filter. Why is it so bad? Who thought this was a good idea? And most importantly, where did this all start? Well, let's talk about that. This concept of replacing bad words with hashtags was first introduced in July of 2013, believe it or not, with their new whitelist system. This was what caused the removal of the old safe chat or menu chat feature, as it allowed users under 13 to be able to type any word on their whitelist rather than having to use the chat menu. This was met with, well, mixed reactions across the forums and various other places. Some were upset about the removal of safe chat, some were upset about the bad filter, some were just confused as to what was even happening, and some didn't really care at all. Looking back though, this new filter really wasn't that bad. Sure, it wasn't perfect, but it wasn't nearly as terrible as some people were making it out to be. The filtered words were reasonable, not too restrictive if you were over 13, and couldn't be bypassed easily. So where did it all go wrong? How did we go from that to this? Well, nothing really happened up until recently. Fast forward to late 2016. Everything seemed to be fine with the chat filter. It was near impossible to bypass at this point. The filtered words were still reasonable, and most people seemed to be happy with it. That is, until recently. Fast forward once more to early 2017, and things got bad. We're talking really bad. It got bad to a point where you can't even say mama. You can't say numbers, you can't type select usernames in the search bar, you can't have a title for your game, and you can't have a description for your game. Essentially, if you can imagine it, it's probably filtered. That's powering imagination for ya. As if that wasn't counterproductive enough though, it's extremely easy to bypass. If you literally just put one letter in the middle of a swear word, or simply remove a letter, it'll go through no problem. I wish I was joking. Here, allow me to demonstrate. Okay, maybe a demonstration isn't necessary. I think you get the point. How'd this happen so fast, though? There has to be some sort of logical reason for this. Was it a mistake? Well, unfortunately, no, this isn't a mistake at all. This was caused by the one and only extremely reputable mainstream media. Don't we just love them? Over the past 6 months or so, an unbelievable amount of hit piece articles have suddenly been popping up slandering Roblox for supposedly being dangerous to children and being filled with child predators, as if this is something unheard of for an online game. Seriously, just look up Roblox on Google and click news. Every result is the same thing, fear-mongering gullible parents into thinking that most users on online games are pedophiles, when in most cases, these people are just 11-year-old boys desperately trying to find a virtual girlfriend. All of this creates more questions than answers, though. The biggest one being, what started this bandwagon in the first place? I've got your answer right here, pal. It's a certain something that I may or may not have reviewed back in January. If you guessed The Last Resort, then you're wrong, because that's not even a review. On the flip side, though, if you answered Meep City, then you're absolutely correct! I think I can say pretty confidently that Meep City is the main cause of this sudden outcry from parents. If you're wondering why, then I'm guessing you haven't played the game for more than 5 minutes, if at all. The problem lies not so deep within the game, in a little feature called parties. Yep, that wasn't predictable at all, now was it? As you may recall from my review of this game, parties are basically the most disastrous part of the game. If you only watched my review of the game and never actually played it for yourself, then I imagine it didn't look that bad to you. But trust me, what I showed in my review is only the most harmless portion of these parties. Once this whole Roblox is unsafe for children bandwagon started popping up, it became unstoppable. As we speak, these articles are still coming out, and to think this was all because of Meep City. Obviously, Alex Neutron had to take some sort of action, right? Here's a long list of things he did to ensure that Meep City would be a kid-friendly game to appease the media. Removed the ability to have beds in your house when hosting a party. Changed the crying animation to be in a completely different pose. That's it! Unsurprisingly, this wasn't nearly enough to stop the media from continuously attacking him, his game, and even Roblox itself. But at least it's a good start. While we're on the subject of things that were changed due to this outcry, let's talk about what Roblox itself changed to accommodate for this. As I'm sure you're aware, this is what caused the filter to have a sudden turn to the stricter side of things. While I do really hate what they've done to the filter, it only makes sense from a business standpoint due to the fact that they were receiving a lot of bad publicity for this. It would only be logical for them to make everything more strict to possibly ensure that the media would stop attacking them. Some other changes that they made include making it show very clearly whether a player is over or under 13, so that way parents can catch their kids lying about their age. Making it so that players under 13 are not allowed to play games that don't have the filtering enabled feature on. Tons of new parental controls that may or may not be necessary. And finally, releasing a long blog post about how safety is their top priority. So, what do you think? Is this going to help their reputation at all, or is the media going to continue attacking them since they know it'll get them clicks on their articles? Personally, I don't think this is going to help very much, if at all, simply because the filter is so easy to bypass and so counterproductive that it only made the media's points seem more valid than they actually are. While I completely understand why they did this from a business point of view, they still need to make some serious changes to this filter if they want to actually make the game more safe. Be sure to let me know in the comments what you'd like me to discuss next. I'm gonna stop talking now.